tying ugly ass shoes on.
Go watch your mouth,
Joy.
Alright,
alright.
Some fucking pointy ass feet.
Sound
like pigeon nose.
Oh.
Your toes, nigga, like I got a beak. I ain't got a beak on the front of your toes.
That
motherfucker got a talent. Talent in that bitch.
Talent. Talent in that bitch.
We relax, nigga. We in our own comfort zone, man. Come out with one
to
come.
You understand?
It's bad for
them. I understand you ain't got image at the hole, yo. I understand that. Some people don't think the same.
We relax today. Y'all might try that shit.
You know your image is a little sketchy.
He's going up.
Are we ready, son?
I've been ready.
Man, can you stop saying you've been ready like you be?
I've been ready, George.
Come on, man. You ain't been in a month of Sunday. Got another special guest today.
But I don't know why. Turn the iPad right there. What you got? You got a motherfucking hit. I'm about sick of social media, I'm not gonna lie. I was never a big fan of it, and I don't wanna sound like an old man with it, but I know some of a big fan of it, and now, the more I get involved in it, the more I see why I wasn't.
Well, you know I wasn't. Yeah. Just because of this, I'm really more adapted to social media just because of this.
So, what I was saying was, I'm trying to, like, it's be like right now in society right now today, there's a lot of crimes involved with women in it. I mean, rather they being shot, killed, whether they shooting somebody, killing them, or I mean, what the last couple of weeks he's been with the kids things, second time two kids been murdered
in less than a month, right?
Yeah, and this is crazy. But the other one riding around with the stink.
That still fucked me up because I don't even know how you can. Like I said, we rolled up the road and something was on the side of the road that was dead. And you smelled that shit. Like, how are you getting in the car with carcasses in the back?
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like what y'all think it is, these women? Like, what is it? Is they high?
I don't know.
Y'all saying it's, you saying it's what you call it?
He says mental health.
Mental health? Now, you think they on drugs?
I think a lot of people. See, it was always taboo for black folks in the black community for them to have anybody in the family to show any signs of mental health or anything like that, you know. Oh, yeah, you know, I'm not crazy, you know. So it was always one of the things we didn't want to talk about it. We wanted to, you know, act like it's not happening, like it's not. No, this shit is real. People be having issues. They need to be addressed, and they're not being addressed.
Right.
Then you have situations when people, and low income people, that may not have insurance, so they don't even know where to even go.
Right. It's such a hard answer for that stuff.
Right. Get the proper treatment.
And in Chicago right now, they're doing a big mental health counseling thing for a lot of people. That doesn't have insurance and stuff like that.
Yeah, but
and this with politicians.
They still had to volunteer.
I understand that, but people want help. But some people want help, they don't have the funds. Or they don't have the right people to talk to.
A lot of people who need it because of the trauma that's going on in Chicago.
Exactly. And politicians, listen, you judges, you politicians, you prosecutors, everybody else want all want to have their goddamn toes and everything. People want help. But they don't want no backlash in the process of them getting the help. What I mean by that is, I need help, but I don't want you to take my kids away. I love my kids. You know, I'm not going to do nothing to my kids, but I need that help because I don't want to go that route.
That's what I'm saying.
You see what I'm saying?
That's always been the problem. Black folks don't want that stigma put on.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? So it was always, I need the help, but that's a prime example. That's a good analogy. When you get that stigma on you now, are they going to start looking at me cock-eyed and they want to take my kids?
Right.
And,
right.
And
see, you know what I'm saying? It's them.
From the home.
It's them.
But these people say they should never had kids, yo.
Yeah, some of these people.
I think it's a bigger problem with women and kids. Is just it's getting sickening to me. I just think it needs to be a better responsibility at the beginning when somebody's about to have a child. I mean, it's hard to, I know it's hard to dissect, but at the end of the day, there's a lot of women out here having kids. I just look at it like, I don't even know why you shouldn't even have them. Mm-hmm. Like, you shouldn't even be having them.
I'm happy you said that.
I'm sick of these irresponsible women, yo.
Now I want to go back to when I said about the court system.
They keep trying to blame men. That's not having to do with men.
Now let's go back to the court system. That's why I ask people, do you believe that the court system has failed us as a family on many occasions over and over and over again? And I believe so. Because I believe this. And it's like a setup to me. And see, you don't want me to, you know, I'm a conspiracy guy and all this. I think it's out the box, ladies and gentlemen. So, this is the deal. If you have a court system, right, and they picking and choosing who the kid is best to be with and things like that, how would you know? You're not even with these people 24/7. You don't know what's going on. And I believe a lot of these judges, you are fucking biased. The system is fucking biased. What you're doing is you're setting the child up for failure 9 times out of 10. Because I'm going to say this. We raise ourselves and we think that. Now hear me out. Think out the box when I'm talking. It should be a man and a woman in the household together. I don't believe that. I don't believe that needs to be done for a kid to be raised right.
Probably.
Mm-hmm. I believe this, ladies and gentlemen.
Should be one thing in there, that's love.
Co-parenting the correct way. And what I mean by that is, don't let your kid see the negativity between the man and the woman. What you show that kid is the love and the respect that you both have for each other. That way the kid can't play that shit against one another. You don't have to be in the same household with that goddamn child. Respect each other when you're around that child. Don't let that child play your dumbasses out of position.
See, that goes back to what I was just saying about adult things that children don't need to see. You hit the nail on the head.
That's the problem. Co-parenting. Nothing wrong with co-parenting. Everybody's not meant to be together forever. But you're meant to be there for your child for the rest of your life because that's what you're supposed to do.
I mean, I think I'll be a better decision made from the beginning. Rebel.
Paula said that's on the courts, though, Irk. Not the.
And that's why I want to go back.
He said that's on the parents, not the courts.
Who? Huh?
He said that's on the parents, though, not the Irk.
That parents. Is also with the courts. And I'm going to tell you why I call him. I'm going to let you know why I also call him, why I say this. It's because, check this out. If my child is just born, the mother, or vice versa, go downtown and ask for child support. Right? But what if the opposite parent be like, ho, I want to have 50-50 custody as well. And what I mean by 50-50 custody, ladies and gentlemen, is physical and legal. Because everybody, like, we got joint custody, but you're not doing your research. You only have legal. That's it. They don't mainly give it physical to both parents. Okay? You want 50-50 physical and legal joint custody. That's what you want. So, why the fuck is these biased-ass judges picking and choosing on a newborn of who's going to have this much custody. Why not give it to both of them? Let that parent fuck that situation up. Give that parent the benefit of the doubt. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You picking and choosing who the fuck you want
right off the door
to do it. And I hope we have some judges. I hope people got family members that's judges. You motherfuckers are biased. And I'm going to tell you something. You black minority, I say minority judges, you should be ashamed of yourself. Because you are extra biased. Black judges are biased to the core. When it comes down to men and women going in the court, especially black women and men.
Good point. So the parents solve that. Basically, the parents solve the issues. They solve it before it won't make it to court.
I agree. But if you got somebody bitter, they going to court.
And yeah, I think as men, we might got made better decision who we lay with. And some of these women, man.
We got a call over here, T.
That just made me think, but go ahead.
It says, you don't have to be in the same house. Both parents need to be involved, and as far too many times, these mothers and fathers just aren't participating. That's true. But why are the ones that does the thing, why they gotta be punished? And see, that's the thing about when you go into court. They look at the odds of like my brother said.
Because the percentage of us as black men being sorry and shit and not taking care of our kids.
It always the good ones. That's why we can't get laws changed. Yeah. That's why we can't get laws changed. Do you actually believe a man that has the same amount of days as the woman?
Women got a lot of power.
Child support?
Women got a lot of power in court.
If you have the same amount of days, should I be paying child support? Because I make more. You want to punish me because I have a better job, paying job.
I had a homeboy that had custody of his son
and still paying child support. You know why?
The boy lived with him.
You know why?
24/7. You know why? Still paying child support.
Because he make more money. That's dead. He make more money than her, and that's fucked up. Yeah, it should not be like that. What about my other bills in my household? I don't ask nobody to take care of nobody. I don't ask nobody to take care
of nobody. Live with him every single day. It wasn't no, they were splitting no time. Shorty lived with him. Day for day. Sun up, sun down.
That's crazy.
And he was still paying child support.
The court system is so fucked up, and I really believe these delegates, all these politicians in Annapolis, you need to go back to work, baby. You need to go back to work. Because a lot of these parents, not just females, males, everybody use that child, man, as a goddamn key to kick the other parents in the ass.
Leverage point.
They use it, man.
Use them as leverage.
And it's a damn shame. And I don't know when these goddamn judges, man, gonna wake the hell up, man, and do what's right. It's like the system is designed for a fuck up. Because they need somebody else to fall in their system. See, this the meal ticket. This the meal ticket. I want people to understand this. Now think about this. This is facts. You have a father, and I'm gonna say this because I'm on a man spectrum. You have a father. This ain't happened to me, not yet. You have a father that take care of the child. Do what he need to do. The child is okay. The mother better. She don't get what she want when she want it. She take the man downtown, right? Now, 5, 6, 7, 10 years, this man been doing nothing but love and showing affection for that child, right? She take him downtown now because of shit not working her way. And then she get all this, the peanut gallery in her ear, right? Once you take that man downtown, okay, damn, yo, she took me out. That's fucked up. I do everything I'm supposed to do. And she gonna fuck me over like this. Now you get them people involved with your situation, right? The most thing happened out of that is what? Now, he's cutting back now. He's cutting.
He's gonna get bad. He's gonna get a bad minimum.
He's getting a bad minimum now. Mm-hmm. And the bad minimum can go all the way to me not even seeing my child as much because I got a chip on my shoulder as well. See, people don't think of that shit, man.
Gotta call him.
It's consequences come with this shit. What? You niggas need to wake the fuck up, man. Stop being so fucking bitter about the shit. It ain't about you. It's about the fucking child.
But y'all ain't working out. Go ahead.
Carla said, we know that the courts are flawed. He said, but it goes back to what Kel said. You have to make better choices in life. Pick a better partner to lay with before you have kids. That's fact.
Listen. Time out. People that lay down with people that was great and the relationship was good for years and then they had a kid and all that shit. Then what happened? Womp womp. When you don't know who the fuck you dating half the time these days.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
These motherfuckers mentally fucked up. That mentally fucked up shit might don't kick in until 10 years down the line.
So you've been sleeping with the representative all that time.
The whole time. Don't it happen?
Yeah, it do.
You don't know. The thing is, all I'm doing is and saying is, the fucking system need to do the right fucking thing. Listen, I want to let y'all know something. You hearing it? You hearing it from me, because it's real shit, and I'm tired. Because you don't think, if you look at the story to these two kids, it's more to this shit. Okay? It's more to this shit. The system ain't shit.
My problem with everything
the system
is that
ain't
women,
good people.
Is that the women have far too much power than a man who is equally responsible for having the child.